I had like this pimple on my forehead, and then I decided to pop it right before I filmed. Like, that's not a good idea. Why would I do that? Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jasmine. If you have no idea who I am, I'm a first generation low income undergraduate at Stanford University, and I made this channel to help other first generation low income students get better access to higher education through my college related videos. First of all, Happy New Year! I know when I upload this, it's gonna be January 1st of 2021, and that means that this year is gonna be super memorable for a lot of you watching, because this might be the first year that you are entering college. This might be the first year you're entering your second year, your third year, your final year of college. Either way, I know we can all agree that we want to leave 2020 back in the past and want to welcome the new year, which is why I wanted to make this video to reassure you and put you on the right track. Because in today's video, we're going to be answering the question, I finished applying to all of my applications, so what now? Well, now you wait. And that's pretty much all you do. That's pretty much the whole video. So I hope this video was helpful. Please let me know down in the comments below. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you for watching, JK. But seriously, there's not much that you can do beyond this. After you submitted your application, you submitted it. You can't really change it unless your school asks you specifically for maybe additional information. I know UC Berkeley, when I was applying, did ask some students for an additional letter of recommendation. These students are usually on the borderline of admissions. I know a handful of my friends got this notification that they should submit a letter of recommendation, and I didn't, and I was like, damn, this means that I didn't get in because all of my friends are getting in, and I'm pretty sure all of my friends are getting in. And then it turns out I did end up getting in. So I'm pretty sure this additional information that they ask from any university, it doesn't only have to be UC Berkeley. I'm pretty sure other universities also ask for additional information. It's usually for students who are on the borderline. So if your school does ask for additional information, I recommend making it very, very good information so that it's convincing enough to flip your decision to a yes admitted. Other than that, there is a debate on whether or not you just completed the hard part. For me, yes, I reread all of my essays 100 times. I got tired of reading them. I looked over my application 100 times. I tried to make sure everything was perfect, and it was a drag. It was so time consuming. Every minute of my free time was spent trying to perfect my college application, and it was a lot of work. So that could arguably be the hard part, but for me, the hard part was waiting. Because for me, I dedicated a lot of my time to school, and I did everything in my power to try to get straight A's, good test scores, or have a ton of extracurriculars and try to be the perfect applicant, and it was so tiring for me. But I know I worked really, really hard in high school and throughout my entire education career for this moment, for the moment that I was gonna know what college I was gonna go to, because my whole life goal at that moment was get into a good college on a good scholarship, and that was the only thing I was working towards my whole life. I dedicated myself to school completely, and I felt that if I didn't get into a good college, then all of that would go to waste, and all of that hard work was just not worth it, and I should have been busy doing something else. So I put a lot of pressure on myself, and the reason why I want to make this video is so that you don't do that to yourself, because that was not okay, and a lot of people just told me to chill out, but I couldn't. And hopefully these words may comfort you in this time that is so, so suspenseful, because I know everyone is just waiting for the admissions results after submitting. It's gonna seem like an eternity, at least for me it was. I was waiting every single day, waiting for an email or notification to check my college portal. Whichever college that was, I was nervous for all of my colleges, even my safety colleges, and I tortured myself. I did not give myself a break, and I don't want you to do the same thing. So my piece of advice for you for your senior year is to chill out and to enjoy your senior year. Enjoy these last moments of high school, because some people you might never see them again in your life, and some people you might keep in touch with, but life works differently for everyone, and it's so funny sometimes, and it's so different. Nobody knows how it's going to go, so I advise that you enjoy it now. Enjoy these memories before they only become memories, and fully appreciate your friends and all the people around you, even though I know it's hard because everything is online and there's not a lot of senior activities, and you know, a lot of stuff are like shut down, you can't really go to the movies or something. But there are still other options that I'm pretty sure other seniors or high schools are doing, and I want you to fully appreciate these moments and this time, because later on in life, you're gonna look back and you're gonna wish that you appreciated it more or you lived in the moment a little bit more. So I wish someone had told me to just accept the fact that I submitted my application, I can't change it, whatever happens, happens. And the decision that I get is not a reflection of who I am as a person. It's not a reflection of how brilliant you are or how intelligent you think you are or how worthy you think you are. And I know a lot of students take these college admissions results to heart, and I know I did for a few of my schools. And just remember that these college admissions officers don't know you. They don't know your entire story. They don't know how amazing you are in person. It might be difficult for you to translate your entire personality onto an essay, on paper, on the screen. And some people can be horrible people, but they write amazing essays and they get in, but they're actually horrible people. And a lot of students are amazing people and they can't write essays. And a lot of that has to do with being in underfunded schools and not having the proper skills or classes that teach you all of these writing strategies. And some schools do, some teachers really try, but for some students it's really hard, and especially if you don't have the resources or if you're worrying about, you know, being low income and having to work after class, you don't really care too much about the writing strategies that you have to learn in class. And that's all part of a system that works to keep the lower class at the bottom, but that's a different conversation for classism in education. What I'm trying to say is that if you're first generation low income, you've gone through a lot, especially in high school, especially applying to colleges, especially taking standardized tests. You don't have the same advantages that other wealthy and racially privileged students do. And you need to give yourself credit for that, regardless of where you do or do not get admitted. I wish someone had told me to not hold so much value and so much pressure on what schools I got admitted and what schools rejected me. Because at the end of the day, everyone is going to love the colleges that they attend. Every single person that I've known loves the school that they attend. And it ends up being like fate. If you do end up getting onto a college campus, which I hope you do, because college life is wonderful pre-COVID, and hopefully it will be wonderful post-COVID. But this whole experience of just meeting new people, having new friends, is an amazing and beautiful chapter in your life. And I really hope you don't put yourself down, because you don't deserve to be put down. And no college should ever have the power to put you down or put you in a bad mood, because you are wonderful and you are brilliant and you guys are amazing. And I also want to make a note to people who do get into good colleges and start thinking that they're better than everyone, because you're not. And I know getting into some really good schools gives you this superiority complex, but that's a myth. Like, there is no such thing as university rankings, and there shouldn't be university rankings, because higher education is difficult for anyone to obtain, especially first generation low income students. And congratulations to you, but you're not better than anyone, and you're not better than anyone going to other colleges. I have a ton of friends in community colleges, and they have so much more information than I do. And a chemical engineering degree at a state school is so much more valuable than another degree at some elite university. All colleges should be celebrated, and all students should feel welcomed and appreciated for their hard work in applying to colleges, because it's a super hard process. And like I said, whether you think applying to college is a hard part or waiting for your college admissions is a hard part, all I want you to know is I want you to live in the moment. I want you to enjoy these final moments of high school. And I also want you to know that these colleges don't know who you are. You hold so much worth and you are so valuable, and your admissions results don't change that in the slightest. One way that I coped with waiting for all of these admissions was just having like the lowest bar possible. I convinced myself that I was not gonna get accepted into any of my universities. So when I did get accepted to my schools, it was a surprise, because I told myself that I wouldn't. And so many people held high expectations of me, and they thought that me getting into Stanford was so like on brand. And of course she got to Stanford, she worked so hard, but in my head, it was way different. It was like, I'm so not worthy and I'm so not good enough for these schools, any school, any like UC Berkeley, any of the UCs. So that when I got rejected from some of these schools, it didn't feel as bad. And it wasn't as surprising, although sometimes it was surprising and it was heartbreaking, it was shattering and I wanted to cry. But I got over it, and you're gonna get over it. And these schools suck. The ones that reject you, they suck. That's all I have to say. That's basically how I wanted to start the new year. I really hope everyone has a wonderful 2021, and remember that you don't have to wait for a new year to do something new. If you want to do something new, do it whenever you want. Do it in February. It doesn't matter when you start doing something new or when you start doing something nice for someone else or for yourself. So I hope this video was helpful. Please let me know down in the comments below. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Follow us on Instagram at First Gen First. We're on Twitter, First Gen First 1. Or send us an email at info@firstgenfirst.org. Bye. Of admissions, I know a little. And I tortured myself. Because you think you're going to say, because you think you're going to